Okay, now settle down. Settle down for three. Today we're going to learn about word stress. So, anyone of you here have an idea about word stress? Yes, Mr. Rivas.
Four.
example, we have the word unforgettable. Miss Ariella, what is your most unforgettable memory? Okay, see that we're still attached to your boyfriend. Ex-boyfriend. Sorry, sir. So, the word here is unforgettable. To locate the root word, we have to dissect the word unforgettable. If you're going to dissect the word forgettable, we'll have 5 syllables. And now, Miss Rigala, can you locate the root of the word? It is the word forget. So now you have to dissect the word forget. So now you'll have 2 syllable word. Now where is the stress syllable? Yes, Ms. Essentia? Very good. On the second syllable of the word forget. So we're going to apply this to the word unforgettable. Where is the stressed syllable? Very good. The third syllable. Okay, now let us pronounce the word correctly. Unforgettable. Again? Unforgettable. Very good. For the second tip, suffixes starting with I or U, the stress goes on the syllable immediately before. Let us have the example words. Essential. Another word. Pacific. So, means for muscle. What is the suffix? The suffix says of the word essential, residual, and opposite. Very good. In the word residual, the suffix is letter U. On the word Pacific, the suffix is letter I. So what is the stressed syllable? The second syllable. Very good. You guys are so very, you're so very cooperative with me today. And thank you for that. So the second syllable is stressed. Let us say the word residual. Again, residual. Very good. Next word, Pacific. Again, very good. So for our third tip, prefixes are sometimes stressed in the face of the word. For example, the word continent, incident, exercise. The prefixes there are stressed. Let me show you. Continent and the word incident. The prefixes of the word con and in is stressed. This is more common in nouns and adjectives and less common in verbs. So we can say that these two words are nouns and are adjective. So for further explanation, I have here the word is continent. Continent is a noun, right? Yes, it is a noun. But the word contain is a verb. And also, the contain is also a verb. And we can see that in these two words, the prefix con is not stressed because it is not a noun or an adjective, it is a verb. Before I proceed to the fourth tip, do you guys believe in the saying that in every room, all you do with that. Okay. So now we can see if that rule is true. We have the word exercise. The word exercise is a noun, and the word exercise is a verb. The prefix here is X. It is said that it's only the noun and adjective that the prefix is stressed, but it is, as I've said, it's less common in verbs. So you can see here that the prefix X is stressed in both noun and verb. For the fourth tip, identical two-syllable words in noun and verb. Many two-syllable words have the same form for noun and verb. In many of these pairs, the verb is stressed on the second and the noun on the first syllable. So I have here with me a list of words which is identical to noun and verb. So let us see the difference between the two. Okay, so what is the question about? So now, so the words here under the verb are these three.
Once and believe. with their corresponding stress syllable. Using these, I want you to construct sentences out of the words listed and presented in the class. You are only given 3 minutes to go and collaborate with your groupmates. Group one.
Yes.
Number one.
Thank you. word stress? Anybody? Okay. Miss Regala. Okay? Can you elaborate to that? In your own opinion, please, in your own words. Okay, very good. How about you, Miss Diaz? Okay? Okay, very good. So, a word stress is a stress or a syllable in a word that is given a more emphasis. Okay, so class, I have here an activity. But first, everyone, please stand up. Okay, everyone stand up. Ni Sutana. Okay, so first, close your eyes. Close your eyes. Then, no one is allowed to open unless I told you so, okay? Okay, so think of a partner. Think of a partner who will not let you down. Okay, think of a partner that will never bring you down. Okay? Okay, how do you think of anyone? Okay, so then I will count to, in 1, 2, 3. Then you will go to your partner in 5 seconds. Okay, so timer starts now. 1, 2, 3, go. Think of your partner, guys. Okay, 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so anyone has a partner? Okay, how many of you here in the class? 20. Miss Diaz, right? 20. Okay, so we all in all we will have 10 pairs. Okay, so here's the instruction. First, your partner will be your opponent. Then, each of you must think of words from a reliable source. You can either use a Merriam or a Google. Then, you are allowed to use your cell phone. And each of you must search up words. Each of you must provide the right word stress. You have 5 minutes to do so. While waiting, please submit a piece of paper with your name. Okay, so time starts now. Okay, 5 minutes, guys. Quiet. So who is absent for today? No one. Okay, 3 minutes left. 10 words in each pair. Okay, 1 minute back. Very good. Miss Alicanto, your turn.
Okay,
Morales, do you agree? That's your Miss Libre. Very good, Miss Libre. Okay, Miss Morales, your turn. Okay, very good. Third word. What was that? Everyone. Okay. Fourth. Very good, Miss Morales and Miss Libre. Okay, Miss Lutero and Miss Abuyo. Okay, very good. Okay. Okay. Miss Abuyo, your turn. One. Very good. And for the last, not the least, Mr. Rivas and Miss Carissa. Where are you? Oh, okay. First word, let's start with you, Mr. Rivas. One. Partner. You agree with that, Miss Rivas? Okay. Very good. Mr. Carissa. Your answer? Okay. Answer? Okay, very good. Okay, so let's give everyone a hand of applause. So guys, I understand that you really understand the lesson. So, I would like to thank you, class, and that would be all. Okay, so class dismissed. But before you go out, please.